Students and welcome back in my second video lecture with the same topic, fundamental unit of life. In my previous video, that is in yesterday video lecture, we have studied about the cell size, how the shape of cell related to functions of cell, and how the organisms are classified into unicellular and multicellular depending upon the number of cells. Also, just in our previous video lecture, we have studied about the basic structure of cell. In my previous lecture, I have told you, so the basic structure of cell consists of cell membrane. At the center, nucleus is there. Between nucleus and outer cell membrane, jelly-like fluid is present, which we call cytoplasm. And many cell organelles are there that is embedded into this cytoplasm. Size of cell. So normally the size of cell ranges from 0.1 micrometer to 18 centimeter. And also I have given you examples. Mycoplasma gallicentrum is the smallest cell in the world, which having size 0.1 micrometer, and the largest cell from animal is an ostrich egg, which ranges up to 18 centimeter. These all points we have discussed in our previous lecture. But though the cell is so small, then the question is who discovered cell and how? So in the discovery of cell, four scientists are majorly contributed in the discovery of cell. They are major landmarks in the discovery of cell. Out of this cell, four scientists, first is Robert Hooke. In 1665, Robert Hooke just observed a thin slice of cork under his self-designed microscope. So what does it mean by cork? Cork is a substance that he derived from the bark of tree. You all know or have heard about the oak tree. So that one of the species of oak tree, from that he just derived cork, and he just observed that cork under his self-designed microscope. But that microscope was not well developed as like our early microscope. So he just saw simple structure like this. When he observed the size of cork under the self-designed microscope, he saw some empty compartments are there, and the structure resembles like structure of honeycomb. So nothing is there inside the cell, all cells were empty. And it just looked like honeycomb. He just gave name to this structure cell. So how he derived this name? Actually, in Latin language, these empty small rooms, compartments are called cellula. So from this word cellula, he just gave name cell to this structure. This is the most important stage in the discovery of cell. Though Robert Hooke observed all these cells, but you all know the outermost part of bark of tree is nothing but an excretory material, and that's why these all cells were there. Means in 1665, Robert Hooke discovered, he just observed the slice of cork under his self-designed microscope, but all cells that he was observed were there. And this structure looks like structure of honeycomb. He just gave name to that structure as cell. Then the second scientist who gave his contribution in this cell theory was organisms in the pond water, and just gave name to them, animalcule. fish. That's why his theory is also an important step in the discovery of cell. So first scientist was Robert Hooke and second Leeuwenhoek. After that, third scientist who gave major contribution in the discovery of cell is Robert Brown. The random movement of microparticles in the given solution. That was not in your syllabus. What is the important part? Robert Brown is actually famous for discovery of nucleus. He was the first scientist who discovered nucleus. I also told you about the basic structure of cell. It consists of nucleus. Nucleus is the most important part of cell because as in our body, heart is important. Without heart, we cannot survive. As like that, if you remove cell nucleus from the cell, then cell will die. That's why nucleus is the most important part of the cell. And this discovery of nucleus is done by Robert Brown in 1831. And the last scientist who gave his contribution in the discovery of cell was J.E. Parmenter.
Structure same. So his discovery is name of the
the name of sale. Then all his discovery, he had just published that discovery, explained that discovery in his book Micrographia. Second scientist is Leeuwenhoek. In 1674, he was the first scientist who observed living organisms, living cells first time, because the cells which Robert Hooke has seen, all cells were dead. But the Leeuwenhoek was the first scientist who first time explained about living cells. And in 1678, he was the first who observed free living cells and just gave name animals. One more important discovery is he was the first who observed human sperms, and also he observed sperm cells of human, dog, rabbit, insect, frog, and fish. Also, he was the first who observed protozoa, bacteria, and red blood cells. After that, Robert Brown in 1831, he was first discovered nucleus, which is the center of cell that we have discussed in our previous video lecture. So Robert Brown just gave the term nucleus. He discovered nucleus, which is fundamental part of, which is the most important part of the cell. And last one is Perkin Jay. In 1839, Perkin Jay discovered, he just coined a new term in science, which is called protoplasm. Nowadays we are using cytoplasm word instead of protoplasm. So these four scientists are the major landmarks in the discovery of cell. These are the four scientists who give major contribution in the discovery of cell. So this was Robert Hooke. He was most important. Why he was most important and his discovery was most important? Because this discovery is the evidence that all organisms are made up of cells. So all these scientists are important in the discovery of cell. In our next lecture, we are going to study about three more scientists, Schilder, Schwann, and Virchow. Schilder and Schwann gave cell theory, and Virchow just modified that cell theory. He just added more points in that cell theory that we will study in our next lecture. So in our today's lecture, we have studied about the discovery of cell, these four scientists and their work related to discovery of cell. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you got all points. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. And just students, listen the whole video. Listen, watch that whole video carefully so that you can give answer or you can write answers of that questions that I will give you in worksheet. Thank you.